I call Bietschhorn an impregnable fortress. I tried to climb it alone, in all seasons, and after several unsuccessful attempts, I finally made it to the top. The first time, winter was still very omnipresent. It was a great adventure. The heavy snow completely exhausted me. Clearly, I lacked physical preparation to face these extreme conditions. The second time, it got too dangerous. It was too hot, and the snow started pouring down the steep slopes.
Je pense que je vais m'arrêter là, parce qu'à cette vitesse-là, ça va pas la peine.
The third time, I almost made it to the top, but I got scared on a tricky passage. The weather became uncertain, preventing me from taking beautiful images of the summit. But ultimately, all of this was just an excuse for my brain to make the decision to give up and come back down. The fourth time, the first snow had arrived in the mountains and thrown a mantle of white around them. I was not physically prepared to face the winter condition, and I stopped at the Bietschhorn Pass, where I contemplated life for a while. The conditions were ideal for taking beautiful images. Then the last time was the good one. I left without any expectations, and when I arrived in Blatten, I saw that there was still a lot of snow, and I hadn't taken adequate equipment with me. I was thinking that it would be very difficult to get to the summit, but I was wrong. You will be able to follow this incredible and unforgettable adventure in 4 or maybe 5 episodes. Please don't hesitate to subscribe to the channel, like and comment on the video. I wish you an enjoyable viewing. The Bietschhorn, nicknamed the King of Valais, is a peak in the Swiss Alps. It reaches almost 4,000 meters above sea level, 3,934 meters exactly. I saw it for the first time during our hike around Sas Almagel. Its characteristic pyramid stands proudly, catching the eye of any mountaineer. When I got home, I rushed to the computer to identify this mountain on Google Earth and to find out the different routes to its summit. To get to the top of this mountain is not a simple walk. You must already have good mountaineering experience, especially when you plan to do it solo. According to the information on the Swiss Alpine Club website, the easiest route is the one leading by the western ridge. This is the one I chose to start my adventure with this incredible mountain. Motivated by my recent success on Bristen, a winter climb, whose video you can see by clicking on the link in the description, I decided not to wait until summer to try to conquer Bietschhorn. As soon as the weather was right, I packed my gear and hit the road. To get to Blatten, which is the starting point, you have to go through the Lutzberg tunnel on a train. This is always an unusual experience for anyone who doesn't live in Switzerland. After a night spent in the car, the mountain welcomed me with a magnificent sunrise. Quick breakfast, and it's time to leave. Arriving during the night, I couldn't see the area around me, but now, with daylight, I find this isolated valley, surrounded by the high snow-capped peaks, extremely beautiful.
Voilà, let's start a new adventure.
It's time to go. I start in the snow, which luckily makes my backpack lighter, because I put my crampons and snow plugs on from the start. My goal for today is to arrive to the refuge and then to climb the pass called Bietschhorn, which connects the Loschental and the Bietschental and to establish my base camp there. At the beginning, the snow is quite hard, which makes me optimistic for the next part of the route. It is not easy to find the path under the snow, but with the GPS, I managed to find my way. Firstly, we cross through a forest. The snow is not too deep, and I can make rapid progress. I leave the forest and pass a fairly deep snowfield on the edge of an abyssal ravine. The snow is getting deeper and deeper, which slows my pace down. I feel tired. I haven't trained in weeks.
It's hard to go in the snow, but more slowly. I did 473 meters.
The summit is hidden behind this ridge, and I think that the refuge is on the top of this hill, and I intend to find a place for my tent on the other side of this vertical wall. In the winter, it's really difficult to find the path under the snow.
I trouvé la flèche, so I need to go a little bit down, and here we can see the water flowing. Now the snow is not hard at all, it's quite soft, so it's hard going. I missed the path. The path is somewhere here, 120 meters from me. So I will try to pass over there and after join the path. Well, I left the forest behind me. It was a mistake. 825 meters, it's 11:30 already. The snow is so soft, cannot go faster, step by step. Well, the path further. It's quite steep. I'm arriving to the ridge of the refuge, I think. It's here. Already 973 meters. I'm not far from the refuge. Hope that it will be easier. And I think that on this side, it would be much easier to go up.
Indeed, when the snow is in the sun, it has time to melt during the day, then freeze at night.
Yeah, tonight I would like to sleep on the ridge, so I need to pass.
I'm not far from the hut. I think I will stop there for the night.
Actually, on this side is a very simple way to come in the winter. Just straight like this. And I came from the right side.
Arriving at the chalet, I am completely exhausted. It's already 2 p.m. It's too late to continue, so I decide to spend the night here. The summit of Bietschhorn is imposing and magnificent. It demands my respect. It's not going to be easy. I look at the wall that stands in front of me to identify the route to take tomorrow. I have to check on my GPS. I figure the summit doesn't look easy, but the wall doesn't look easy either. We will see tomorrow. I decide to set up my tent behind this big rock. It's quite warm here. I chose for my tent the northwest side of the rock, so I can enjoy the sunset. I don't like spending my time preparing the platform for my tent. It's a tedious job. But from experience, I know you have to do it right, or you will have a rough night. The surface must be perfectly flat, with a slight depression in the middle, without which we risk sliding along on the snow during the night, when it melts with the heat of our bodies. Here is my platform. I still have to dig a hole for my legs to be able to sit when I cook or put on my shoes. For the moment, there is no wind, so it's perfect. I still have a magnificent view. It's simply fantastic. It's time to put my tent up. In winter, I use the Makalu tent from Simond. Its advantages: it weighs only 1 kilo, and it's very easy to pitch. When I bought it was 208 euros. Unfortunately, now its price has almost doubled. Many people ask me what equipment I use and why. I take this opportunity to give you some explanations. To sleep, I use a down sleeping bag to save on weight and gain thermal performance. When it's not too cold, for example down to minus 15, I prefer to use two light sleeping bags instead of one. In this way, I manage to better regulate the temperature. I rarely feel the cold. That's why sometimes you can see me in shorts in the winter. You can find details of my sleeping bags in the description. Once emptied, I use my backpack as a pillow. To anchor my tent, I use big stones, and if I can't find any, then I use ice axes, hiking sticks, and a snow shovel. This avoids carrying tent pegs. Now that I have installed the tent, I can dig the hole for my feet, as I explained it to you previously. There you go, it's ready. The location is ideal, with a gorgeous view. Now it's time for food. Firstly, I need to collect clean snow to make the water. Tonight the sun is out. It even forces me to put on my goggles. The sunset promises to be exceptional. When I cook and the weather is good, then I take advantage of this moment of calm to reflect and meditate.
It's time for a small rest. It's still early. Beautiful, beautiful view. It's amazing. And it's a pity that I couldn't go higher.
Now it's time to share with you this unique sunset. The night is calm, no wind. I sleep well.
Well, it's half six in the morning. It's time to have some food and after I go up.
As you can see, in the morning it's always colder compared to the evening. It's not easy to leave the warmth of our bed, to get dressed and to prepare food. It's time to leave. After thinking about it for a while, given the amount of snow and lack of my physical form, I decided to climb only Bietschhorn pass. It would be illusional to think that I could reach higher. It's better to stay prudent, especially since I could not clearly identify the route to take. I also have to adapt my itinerary to to avoid possible avalanches as there is a lot of snow. It's hard to find the right route. The GPS is acting up. It always happens on steep slopes. I'm very happy to come across a post. A kind of indication. It reassures me. The snow is getting deeper and deeper. It's not frozen at all, which makes the ascent more difficult. I'm starting to get tired. I come across a hole just in front of a rock. It's a common occurrence. You always have to be careful not to fall into this hole. It's unpleasant and even dangerous. After a tedious ascent, I finally arrive near the ridge. A few more meters, and I could see what is on the other side, and the route to the summit. I feel quite exhausted. Here I am on the ridge, more than 3,000 meters above sea level. I'm alone. There is not a soul. I decide to climb a few meters higher to have a better view. It's the first time I've been here, and in truth, I'm not at peace. It's always scary to be alone in the middle of the mountains. Finally, I see Bietschhorn closer. It is as impressive as it is intimidating. There is no question of going any further today. The loneliness of this place is already weighing down on me. I'm worried about the descent. I have to stay focused. It's for these reasons that I feel no joy. I have to wait until I'm back in the car to fully enjoy my adventure. It's time to go back down. It's not going to be easy. I have to be very careful not to trip over rocks and not to get caught up in my crampons. It's always easier to climb up, even in the snow. There are passages more delicate than others. Indeed, on this type of ground, there are always many holes, and therefore, regularly, we can sink deep in the snow. Normally, I am always hot from the effort, so I leave my trousers open on the side, and then snow gets inside every time. I always end up having to close them completely. I didn't expect the descent to be quite so technical and tiring. I have to be really careful with every step, so as not to fall and find myself instantly at the foot of this wall. I feel relieved when I find myself on less steep terrain. I can move faster and even slip on my snowplugs. It's not always easy to keep your balance. I finally arrive at the tent. The most difficult part is behind me, even though the risk of avalanche still exists. This time I didn't reach the top. But you have to know your limits and know when to say stop. Although I love to conquer the peaks, I also appreciate these moments of solitude with myself and the mountain. These moments of communion with nature allow me to know myself better and to appreciate my life. Thank you for watching this video to the end, and I invite you to subscribe to our channel and activate notifications so that you can be informed when the second episode of this adventure will be available.
Voilà, je suis remonté en haut parce que j'ai perdu ma caméra. Et donc j'ai bien fait parce que je l'ai retrouvée. C'est top. Bon, là maintenant, normalement c'est ok. Juste, je passe la forêt. La voiture, elle est là.
Well, I arrived at the car park. It was really hard and tiring, but I'm quite happy with my ascent.